Hello everyone, welcome to my channel TechnoEd Learning. Today I'll be showing you how to start with Google Classroom. Google Classroom is an online platform easy to use and provides great teaching and learning experience. So I'll go to this Google tab and I'll go to Google Classroom. Okay, so click on this classroom.google.com. So it will ask us first to sign in with our Google account. So, I'll sign in from my account. Okay. Now it will show me my present classrooms available on this account. These are my present classrooms which are already available. Then to create a new classroom, I'll go to this plus sign which says create or join or create a class. When you are a student, you will have to click on join a class, because when you are a faculty, you are going to create a class. Now, here it is showing that if G Suite is there for an education institution, it is provided with additional privacy and security problems. So now click on this, that is, I have read and understood the above notice, and continue. Now, you will have to write the class name. What I prefer is, I do write the subject name with my name, that is with the faculty name, so that the class is being distinguished by the name of the faculty. So I will say EE by Mrs. Pooja Kadam. Okay, then section I will write the academic year. Subject I'll say environment engineering and room number. Create. Okay, so this will first create my classroom with the name E by Mrs. Pooja Kadam. Okay. So this is how my classroom will look. Now I can change the theme of my classroom by going to this tab, that is select theme. So if I go here, I have already some themes, so which I can select. What I prefer is a different color coding I give to my different classrooms. Okay, so I'll use a theme. Making different color for different classrooms, so classrooms get distinguished by their color code. Okay. So this is how it is selected. You can also change the theme of the classroom by going to this upload photo and drag a photo or select a photo from your computer and upload it as a theme. Okay. So this is how I can change the theme of my Google Classroom. Now since I have created the Google Classroom as faculty, I need students to join this classroom. So for that, I'll go to people. I can even add teachers to this classroom. For example, if there is co-teacher to that particular subject, I can add that teacher into this Google Classroom. Or if I want some teacher to access my content, I'll type his or her email ID and I'll invite them to join my classroom. Okay. For students to join my classroom, I'll have to go here, type the email ID of particular students and invite them. So an invitation to join the classroom will be given to them on their email ID. The second option and the easiest option is go to the stream and you can see here class code. Click on this. This class code we can share with the students, and students can by their own join your Google Classroom using this class code. Okay. So when after the students have joined the classroom, okay, the next is the stream tab, which is the default tab. Okay, here you can share something with class. I'll say welcome all. The sharing can be in the form of text, or you can add a data from Google Drive or link or file or a YouTube video. Okay, now here I can select for which class I have made the announcement. So it is already by default the present classroom. From here I can select that this announcement is for all the students or for particular student. Okay, and then I can post. Before that, here I have an option which says schedule. You can schedule your post that when do you want this announcement to be made. So I can select the particular date and time and say schedule. Now I am posting this. Okay, so this will be posted and all students who have joined will be able to see this announcement. Okay, now next is the upcoming event tab. Now this window shows What are the upcoming events? Say I have given an assignment or quiz and I have assigned a deadline to it, so the upcoming events will show that. So students can go through these upcoming events to do their work on time. Okay. Now the next is classwork and very important tab where the work is to be given to students. Now I'll go to create. Before assigning anything, what I prefer is making topic in the form of different modules of your syllabus. This helps me in classifying all the articles and all the materials in different modules. So I'll say module 1. Add. Next, again, I'll add module 2. And this way I can add different modules depending upon the modules present in my syllabus. Okay. Then next, create assignment. So I'll go to this assignment. I'll say assignment 1. I'll give some instructions which is optional. Assignment now can be created in the form of doc, slide sheets, drawings or forms, or I can add data from Google Drive, a link, a file could be uploaded. Or a YouTube video can be uploaded. Okay. Here also you can select that whether this assignment is for a particular group of students or it is for all students. So by default it is for all students. I can assign points to the assignment. So I'll say 10. You can give due date and time, that is a deadline for submission of the assignment. Okay. And time is optional, but you can give it. And topic. This assignment comes under which topic, that is which module, say module 1. Then you can also give rubric, that is how these 10 points are distributed. So I'll go here and say create rubric. So when I create rubric, I'll have to divide these 10 points into different criteria. So here the first criteria blank is given. So I'll say my assignment 1 is divided into the content, timely submission and Viva on the assignment. So I'll say content. Criteria description, how well the content is described. Then I'll assign points. That is, if I'm giving 3 marks for the content, how is this 3 marks again distributed in the form of rubrics? So I'll say 3, 2, and 1 is the way in which it is distributed. Okay. And 1 means, I'll say it is poor, 1 out of 3, 2 is fair and 3 is excellent. Okay, this becomes my level title. Now what does poor indicate? The content is incomplete or copied. Okay, then fair needs improvement and excellent means very well described. I'll say very well described. Okay, this way you can add the description for that particular level title. So 3 marks are given for this content part. Okay, now next I can add next criteria which will say criteria title as timely submission. Okay. Submitted before due date or not. Here I'll have points, that is, I'll say 1 and 0. Okay. And on time, level title and late submission. Very good. I'll say submitted on time. Okay. Similarly, here I can say delay. Okay, So the total now points becomes 4, that is 3 plus 1. Next, again I'll do add criteria, and then I'll write the criteria title as Viva on assignment. Criteria description, oral exam will be conducted. Let's see. Okay, then points I can decide. Now the remaining points, that is 4 and total marks are 10. So I'll say 6 points are there for this oral examination, which will be divided into 2, 3, 2 and 1. So 3, 2 and 1. Now similarly, I'll give some level title and description. Okay, so it is 3 plus 1, 4. And this. So you can see here the content 3 marks is given. For timely submission, it is 1 mark. Okay. And for Viva assignment, it is total 3 marks. Okay. So I can give here total as 6 marks. So it becomes 10. If you get full 6 marks, then it is best. If you get 4 marks, it is low or 0. I'll say I can distribute the points. So the total marks 10 are thus divided according to the rubrics. So this way I can assign the rubrics and save it. Okay, so my assignment is assigned and also the rubrics are made. The rubrics are made available for the students. Then you can go here and give assignment in the form of quiz as well. This everything is same, just here quiz can be given in this already present blank quiz, or you can add same way a data from drive, link, file or YouTube video, or you can create the quiz. Okay, so I prefer the quiz to be given in Google form. The same way the quiz could be given, the same way the assignment is given. Next, a question can be posted and an answer will be expected from the students, that is short answer. So you can post a question and click on ask. Then what else is there? That you can post material, which is very important in Google Classroom. Whatever materials, be it PDF, be it PPTs, or whatever the content, say some research papers or some video lectures. So you can add the title, you can add the description, and you can add those content. Okay, and also you can select the topic here, in which topic that content needs to be present. Okay. This is how you can add the material also. Next is reuse post. You can reuse a particular post again, and topic I have already discussed. Okay, so this is how this classwork is very important and to be done. The next is the grades. Since now students have not joined, so you cannot see anything on grades. I'll be explaining about it in my next video of Google Classroom, wherein my Google Classroom is already made and students have already joined. Okay. Now, the next is the settings here. Go to the settings. So, you have various settings here. That is already class details which were given. You can edit it here. You can edit whatever you want. And also, there is the general settings. Students can post and comment. So, you can change it. The students can only comment. Only teachers can post or comment. These options you can make. Show deleted items. Then show condensed notifications. Overall grade, how do you want the grade? In total points, overall grade, or no overall grade, or weighted by average, category. So this is how you can even select various setting options. Then show grade to students. Okay, that also you can show. Okay. And you can save it. So this is how the Google Classroom works when you are a beginner. In my next video, I'll be showing you my own Google Classroom and various more options which are available when students join the classroom. Thank you so much.